Hi, I'm Andrew Clark. I live in Chicago, Illinois.
I'm Adriana Johnson, Andrew's girlfriend.
My name is Dylan McCarthy, and that's also what everybody calls me.
Here is Emily, and I'm always ready for new adventures.
I hope you all are ready.
Get ready to deal with my beauty.
Yo.
It's a bit strange when everybody can see me.
You are now about to witness the strength of Greek knowledge.
That's the shit.
Hi.
You won't believe what you're gonna see.
Let's see what's on TV.
Hey, honey.
Yeah, baby.
Can we go out?
Does it really have to be today?
Oh, come on. Can't you be doing something else except for watching TV?
But I have just found an exciting program I wanna see.
Gosh. Men. Always the same.
Alright, I'm gonna come. Just give me 5 minutes.
Isn't that restaurant a nice one, Eric?
Yeah, it sure is.
Have you already decided what you want to eat?
Well, I'd like to have the Salisbury steak with potato gratin and green salad.
Well, madam, that is a great choice, since we are well known for our fresh and crispy meat. And you, sir?
Well, not sure. I'm still checking the menu.
Alright then. Tell me when you found something.
Honey, why didn't you choose the same meal as me?
To be honest, I don't eat steaks often. That's why I'm still unsure.
Holy fuck. So that's what they call fresh fish? I'm gonna complain.
Well, I better don't select anything with fish. Maybe rather the same menu as you.
Oh my god.
What the fuck is this?
That, my friend, is called methylated spirits.
Time to get out of here.
I need to call the fire department as well as an ambulance. Unfortunately, I left my phone at home.
Don't worry, I'll do that for you.
What? What's going on?
Well, just for your information, somebody set the restaurant on fire.
Wait, what am I waiting for then?
I think I'm fainting.
That's not what our Friday evening should have turned out to be.
Definitely not. But I've seen the asshole who caused the fucking fire.
My restaurant. The best piece of my heart.
So, Mr. and Mrs. Jolicoeur, you say you have seen the arsonist?
I have. And so did my wife. He was muscled, in his early 20s and wore a dark gray jacket and tie as well as some sunglasses. Of course, the sunglasses were on his head.
Thank you very much, sir. That shall be important informations for the identikit.
He's lying. He himself caused it.
Absolutely correct. He was sitting on the table the fire went on. And when he came in, he was looking very grumpy. I bet he just wanted to watch football at home.
What? Eric? Is that true?
But honey, how the fuck could I have done that? You have seen everything I've done. And you have also seen that dude rushing in. He was even scheming at us and telling it were methylated spirits he put on our table. Come on, Taylor. Believe me. Please.
You're right, honey. I must have overseen that. Sorry for going mad on you.
It's okay, baby. Nothing happened.
I am very sorry to interrupt your conversation, but I am afraid we cannot ignore the witness testimonies of the two young men.
I 100% agree with my Australian colleague. So, as a matter of fact, you, Mr. Jolicoeur, are coming with us to the police headquarters.
What?
You must be fucking kidding me. You just heard what me and my wife were talking about.
We heard, but it stands in conflict with what the two witnesses said.
Indeed so. If I was you, I would be listening to the police.
Fine. I'm coming with you just to prove you the truth. Come on, Taylor. Let's get the police headquarters.